It's the Newlywed Game! And here are today's newlyweds. This couple marched down the aisle 15 months ago, Sonia and Sal Ramirez. Our next couple sliced their wedding cake 15 months ago, Yanira and Victor Arocha. This couple became husband and wife 22 months ago, Demetrius and Kevin McLaughlin. And our final couple traded vows 12 months ago, Carrie and Tom Woods. And now, here's the star of the Newlywed Game, Bob Eubank.
Welcome to the Newlywed Game. We're so glad you could join us today and say hi to our four couples. How are you guys?
Pretty good.
Hey. Well, good. You ready to play the game?
Yeah.
Then
yeah.
Let's take the ladies off to the soundproof booth and I'll ask the husband some questions. Okay? Ladies, if you would, please. And gentlemen, round one, we'll be asking you some five-point questions. You'll answer these questions as you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. Now remember, if her answer matches your prediction, you get 5 points. And each correct prediction will bring you closer to your fabulous second honeymoon. So the ladies are gone, and gentlemen, here's your first question now for 5 points. Tell me, guys, which of the following will your wife say is the strongest drive? Her hunger for food, her hunger for shoes, or her hunger for sex? Which is the strongest drive, Ron?
Her hunger for food.
For food?
Yeah, because she's always talking about she's hungry.
I'm sorry.
So she...
Victor.
For food.
For food. Yeah, hunger for food.
Oh, she can eat.
She got away.
Definitely eat.
The girl can put it away, is what you're telling me. Sal?
It's definitely food.
Her food?
It's food.
Her hunger for food.
Sex is the last one.
I'm really sorry. And not as sorry as you are, but I am really sorry, yeah. Kevin, you almost kind of blend in with the pillow there, pal.
I have to say food.
Wait, did the whole band get that outfit or just you?
Just me.
And you look cool, man. What would it be, Kev?
I'd have to say food, too.
It's her hunger for food.
She's always eating.
All right. Next question, gentlemen. What will your wife say is the last food that somehow got involved in your lovemaking together? Victor?
I'd say tacos.
Not with a 10-foot pole, man. Sal?
It's just a craving for, like, corn nuts or something like that.
Corn nuts? Kevin?
I have to say ice cream.
Ice cream got involved
ice
in your...
Get it going.
You kinky little devil,
that's
you.
That's right.
Yeah. What do you think, Ron?
Potato chips.
Potato chips? Gentlemen, how will your wife say you would complete this sentence? This is you talking. Our marriage has the good, the bad, and the ugly. When we make love, it's good. When we fight, it's bad. But when we blank, it's just plain ugly. Fill in the blank for me, please. Sal?
It's all right when she complains. When she complains.
When she complains, it's really ugly. Okay, I'll take it. Don't want to, but I will. Kevin, what do you do that's ugly?
I'd have to say her family.
So basically, when we talk about her family, it's ugly. Or her family's ugly.
Ain't none of them good. Ain't none of them good.
Well, there surely must be one good one among the whole bunch, isn't there?
Nah.
No, they're all bad.
They're all bad.
And ugly.
Ugly, too.
Ugly. Woo!
Ugly.
Got ugly sisters.
Yeah.
Ugly brother.
I got the best one out the bunch.
You got the cream of the crop.
Got the cream of the crop.
Rest of them are ugly.
Every last one.
Is that right?
That's right.
How ugly are they?
Can't say on national
okay,
TV.
Okay, I see. But Ron, when we blank, it's ugly.
When it comes to washing the dishes.
When we wash the dishes, it's ugly.
That kitchen is something else.
Okay. Victor.
Right about now.
Ironing the clothes.
When we iron, it's ugly. All right, gentlemen, thank you very much. We'll be right back to reunite the newlyweds, and we'll see how well our husbands have predicted what their wives will say right after these messages.
Join me, Bob Eubanks, for my picks from Card Sharks, Match Game, Hollywood Squares, Family Feud, and The Newlywed Game. It's the best of Bob during Bobtober on Buzzer.
Starts tomorrow at 8.
We'll be right back.
to the Newlywed Game. We're glad you could join us today. And gentlemen, we've recorded your predictions on cards. You now have them in front of you. Each time that your prediction matches your wife's answer, you get 5 points. It's the one couple with the most points at the end of the show that wins our fabulous second honeymoon. Isn't that amazing how that works? Get more points, you win. Ladies, nice to have you with us. We had some fun while you were gone. Tell me, ladies, which of the following would you say is your strongest drive? Would that be your hunger for sex, your hunger for food, or your hunger for shoes? Shemetrius, which is your strongest drive?
My hunger for food.
For food, really?
Yeah.
It's not sex?
No. Not at all.
Would it be safe to say that shoes comes before sex even?
Oh, no.
No, not that far. Kevin said that you're hungry for food. Yeah. Sonia.
Oh, it's got to be food.
For food. See, he says definitely. It definitely is your hunger for food. Yeah. Is she sexy?
Yes.
Is he sexy?
Yes.
But you like food better?
Food.
Yes. Yanira, your strongest drive?
I'd have to say food.
For food?
He says I'm always eating.
All right. Your husband predicted you would say it's your hunger for food. You got it. Yeah. What do you think about this, Carrie?
Oh, it's food.
Is it really?
I love food, yes.
It's food over
it's
sex?
Food, yes.
And which would come
I love
in second?
Food. Sex.
Sex. All right. He said it's your hunger for food. Yeah. Speaking of that, ladies, what is the last food that somehow got involved in your lovemaking together? Sonia.
That would be. Jelly?
Pardon me? That would be what?
Jelly. That would have to be jelly.
Dilly?
Jelly.
Oh, jelly. Oh.
You okay. You got me there. That wasn't me.
He said the last food would be, corn nuts.
You eat them? She's always eating them. They're all over the house. They're rolling around on the floor. So I figured that's good. They gotta
be in
there
somewhere. Better than yours, man. Come here, honey. I got some corn nuts for you. Yanira, last food.
Whipped cream.
I think. Really, whipped cream?
It's sweet and it's not so messy.
No kidding. Does your mother know about this?
No.
Mom, whipped cream. Victor said, Mom, tacos.
He always...
Carrie!
Oh, my gosh, he's got to get this right. Oh,
I hope so.
Ice.
Pardon me?
Ice.
It's not even... Ice?
Oh, my God, I know you said ice.
Oh.
I know you said ice.
You have told the entire country about ice. Oh, and missed the answer. He said, card please, potato chips.
No.
Ice is not even food.
You don't have to worry about ice no more, though.
Demetrius, last food that got involved in your lovemaking.
Well, it's been a while, but I think it was ice cream.
Ice cream. He said it's been a while, but he thinks it's ice cream. Yeah. All right. Next question, ladies. How did your husband complete this sentence? This is him talking. He said, our marriage has the good, the bad, and the ugly. When we make love, it's good. When we fight, it's bad. But when we blank, it's just plain ugly. Yanira?
When I lose my temper, it's bad.
When you lose your temper. He said, when you iron the clothes, it's just ugly.
Oh, you know you hate ironing clothes?
It's
ugly.
No.
Okay, Carrie?
Argue.
When you argue, it's ugly.
Yes.
He said, card for me, please.
Yes.
Yeah. When you wash the dishes, it's ugly.
You know you don't like doing the dishes. You know that.
So much for the ice, huh, Ron? Demetrius, what do you do when it's just ugly when the two of you...
When we have to clean the house?
Wait, no, you know what he said? Kevin said it's when you deal with your family. Hey, let me tell you. Shavit, he said
your mother stays with us. How come it's my family?
He said your sisters are ugly. He said your brothers are ugly. He said your family's ugly.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Every last one.
Sonia.
Okay, that would be organizing the socks.
I beg your pardon?
Well, there's nothing worse than having making pairs.
Sal, no wonder your sex life's down the tube. She's out there organizing the socks. Now it's when you complain all the time.
About
it's ugly.
True.
All right, we'll be back with the wives to see how well they can predict what their husbands will say.
Those nutty newlyweds and me, Bob Eubanks, coming up on Buzzer.
Game. Now, ladies, your husbands are secluded off stage. It's your turn to predict what they will say. And remember, these questions will now be worth 10 points. Here's our first one. Ladies, if people wore bumper stickers the way cars do, which of the following will your husband say he would pick for your rear fender? Caution, wide load ahead, or if you can read this, you're too damn close. Yanira?
Wide.
Wide load ahead.
He says I have wide hips.
Sonia?
I think that... Too close one?
Okay, if you can read this, you're too damn
you're
close.
Too damn close.
Okay. Shemetrius?
He would say too damn close.
If you can read this, you're too damn close. All right. And Carrie?
My husband is so protective, he's going to say, if you can read this,
you're too
damn close.
If you can read this, you're too close. All right, next question, ladies. Now, think about this. This is a very serious question. During mating season, the Bora Bora dicky bird parades around flapping its dorsal flipper. Did you know that? Now, keeping this in mind, what specifically will your husband say is his strangest or most unusual mating ritual? Sonia, what would that be?
That would be pinching.
Pinching.
Yeah.
I see.
I have to pinch my, you know.
So he never flaps his dorsal flipper. He pinches.
No.
I see.
No, yes, he pinches.
He pinches.
He will come back and pinch, you know.
So that's romantic as heck, isn't it? Yeah. Shemetrius. He's obviously a very romantic guy.
Well, he likes to get naked and pray in the house.
He gets naked?
Yeah. He starts taking off his clothes, and then he'll parade around the house naked, and then he'll go get in the bedroom.
And he parades around in the house.
And he waits for me.
Yeah.
I guess that's my hint to come
in. Yeah,
I
guess so. So when he parades, you mean he just literally parades?
He takes off his clothes, he walks around, he eats, he watches TV, and then he goes into the bedroom.
And he gets naked.
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't ever invite me to your house for dinner, all right? What do you think, Carrie?
I think he chases me around the house.
He chases you around
the house? Yes.
Do you run fast?
Well, you know, not too fast so that he can't catch me.
I got you. Okay. Yeah. All right. Yanira.
I don't know about strange, but I know he dances.
Like how?
Like a worm.
He dances like a worm. What does he have on when he does this?
Just his underwear, and then he just flings it off.
He dances like a worm and flings off his underwear. Boy, I bet that's a turn on. Man. Okay, here's our 25-point bonus question. Ladies, what will your husband say is the furthest city listed on your most recent long-distance bill? Carrie?
I'm going to say Las Vegas.
Las Vegas. Yanira?
I'm going to say Seattle.
Seattle. Sonia?
Las Vegas.
Las Vegas. Shemetrius.
Louisville, Kentucky.
Louisville. Louisville, Kentucky. All right, ladies, thank you. We'll be back with the husbands to compare answers on the Newlywed Game right after these messages.
What are they talking about?
Liza Minnelli for hot dogs.
They're talking about Talk About.
Prince Charles is right.
Yeah! Weekdays at 8, right here on Buzzer.
everybody. I'm just taking a look at our scoreboard. All of our couples have scored some points. Now let's see if you can add to that total right now. Because, gentlemen, we're going to see how well your wives have predicted what you will say. And remember, these questions will be worth 10 points. And here's our first 10-pointer. Gentlemen, if people wore bumper stickers the way cars do, which of the following would you pick for your wife's rear fender? If you can read this, you're too damn close. Or, caution, wide load ahead. Sal, which one would you pick?
Caution, wide load.
Wide load ahead, she said. Caution.
No.
Oh, if you can read this, you're too damn close. Oh. You can't tell me she's... No.
I'm not wide.
Victor, which one of those?
If you're too close, can't read this.
She said that you would put on there, caution, wide load ahead.
Why would I... You've always said that I'm wide, but I'm not. I know I'm not.
He says you're wide?
Yeah, he says it, but I know I'm not.
I never say that. Oh, that wasn't me.
You say she's wide?
I never say that. I love my wife.
Ron, if you can read this, you're too damn close, or caution, wide load ahead.
If you read this, you're too damn close.
All right, let's see what she said. If you can read this, you're too close. Yeah. Kevin.
You're too damn close, you can read this.
Okay. She said, if you can read this, you're too close. You got it. Okay. Good for you. All right, gentlemen. Now, this is a very serious question. I want you to consider this question as serious. It's educational, and it's something that you should think about seriously. During the mating season, the Bora Bora Dicky bird parades around flapping its dorsal flipper. There'll be a written test on this. Keeping this in mind, what specifically is your strangest or most unusual mating ritual? Victor?
I guess acting like a monkey or something. She said that about me before.
No, she said that you dance like a worm and you fling your underwear.
I don't dance like no worm. I'm not that skinny.
Hey, dancing like a worm is a heck of a lot better than acting like a monkey.
Yeah.
Okay.
We have time. Would you dance like a worm for us? Sit down. Ron, what's your strangest, Ron, most unusual mating ritual?
Well, let's see. She's always saying I'm horny, so. So I guess it would be just dancing with her, playing with her, feeling on her, touching her.
That's about 7 answers, Ron. You left one out. She said what you do is you chase her around the house.
You always chase me. You always chase me. Oh, my gosh.
Hey, I don't blame you. She's got the ice. Kevin, I want to know, and her family wants to know, your strangest or most unusual mating ritual now, Kev.
I'd say I dance in front of her.
You dance in front of her?
Dance in front of her.
All right. She
Kevin,
said,
now, what Kevin, do you do before you start dancing? You take off your clothes.
And then you parade around the house.
You got to do that too, you know. It works together, man.
Is that right?
That's right.
Okay. I'm afraid to ask old Sal this question. Sal, what is your strangest or most unusual mating ritual, Sal?
Probably I take off most of my clothes and then I kind of just crawl up and sneak up behind her or just sneak up on her.
Boy, you're a romantic devil, aren't you? First of all, he takes off most of his clothes.
Oh, well, but
leaves
his
shoes on.
Socks. The socks.
Sonia says that you pinch her.
And you go around.
All right, before we get to our 25-point bonus question, let's see where our winning couple will be going on their second honeymoon.
You're going to Cabo San Lucas. Hotel Cabo San Lucas is a complete beach resort where you can do everything under the sun or nothing at all. White sand beaches, elegant dining, and deluxe accommodations, all with private terraces. Back to you, Bob.
Thank you, Kramer, very much. All right, gentlemen, here it is, your big 25-point bonus question. For 25 points, gentlemen, what is the furthest city listed on your most recent long-distance bill? Furthest city. Couple two, Sal and Sonia with five. 25 will give you 30. Get it right, you'll be in first place. Sal?
Las Vegas.
Las Vegas. She said it was Las Vegas. You got it. Couple number three, Victor and Yanira. You have five. 25 will give you 30. Get it right, and you're tied for the lead. Victor?
Seattle.
Seattle. That's what she said. Seattle. Couple number four, Ron and Carrie Woods with 15. 25 will give you 40. Take over the lead with the correct answer, Ron.
Sacramento.
Sacramento. She said, no, Las Vegas. Couple number one, Kevin and Shemetrius. You have 20. 25 will give you 45. If you get it right, you're going to Cabo San Lucas. Kev?
Louisville.
Louisville. She said Louisville. Yeah! And Kevin and Shemetrius, you're our Newlywed grand prize winners. Well, thanks to all of our couples. Thank you, folks at home. I'm Bob Eubanks, and we will see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
It's Super Password. Our special guest this week, from 227 and Another World, Jack A. Harry. And from Newhart, Tom Poston. And the star of Super Password, Bert Cundy.
Thank you. Here we go. Thank you. Thank you very much, and welcome. Welcome to the last show of the week on Super Password. It has been an enormously exciting time. I've had a great week enjoying watching you guys play, even though I do play right along with you. But I hope you'll come back again, Jacquet, will you? Because you've been sensational. It's been great meeting you.
I'll come back.
Please. Please do. Are you going to come back too, Tom?
Well, was she a teacher? Were you a teacher, Jacquet?
Uh-huh. I used to teach history.
Is that right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. She's smart.
Yeah,
good player.
Very
good,
smart. Good very, player. Very smart. You have done very well today, too, though.
Well, I'd love to come back.
Well, I didn't say that. I just said you've done very said you've done very well today.
The question is when I want to, not when you want me to.
Oh, I
yes,
see.
I'll
I'm
be
sorry.
Back tomorrow. You. Oh, all right. Okay. I'll come back whenever you want me.
Oh, I'm thank you very much, sir. We'd love to have you, right, guys?
I'd love to do it.
Yeah.
Games on television. I love this game.
Thank you. I do too, as a matter of fact. And here are two people who are going to love us to death if they can win some money, and they're going to come out and try it now. Come on out here, won't you, Wendy and Don, please? Okay, Wendy, Don. Wendy, tell us about yourself once again, please, and we'll get rolling.
Okay, my name is Wendy Muscariello. I'm living in Dana Point, originally from Palm Springs. And I am so thrilled to be here.
Yes, well, thrilled to be here from Palm Springs. Palm Springs is a nice place to be in the winter, too.
Very nice.
Yeah, imagine all those people out there struggling with the snow and so forth. Oh. We're here having a nice day. It must be 85, 90 outside, right? At least. Don, tell us about yourself again, sir.
Yes, I'm Don Hawkins, and I'm an attorney here in Southern California. I'm formerly a career aviator, having flown 5,000 hours as pilot in 18 different types of aircraft. And yesterday morning, right here on this stage, I realized one of my longtime ambitions, and that was to be a contestant on Super Password.
Wow. Wow. This man is all right in my book. Thank you, Don. That's really sweet.
I want you to represent me.
Yes, you can represent me anytime. I would love to find out all about
your
cards. You do? No, I don't.
What I they said we couldn't say anything about a profit-making organization, but I don't know if that attorney, is that called a profit-making?
Oh, yes. We don't have any telethons for attorneys that I know of, but I'm glad you're here, and I'd love to find out more about
the flying.
Maybe we'll have time to do that. But in the meantime, here's a $200 puzzle. If you're ready to go, gang, let's do it, shall we? We're playing for $10,000 over there in the end game, and the cash word is worth $2,000. And Wendy and Don will be giving the clues. And here comes your first word. There it is. Don, if you will lead us off, please. Can you see it in there okay? Don, are you there?
Yes. How'd you like to have him flying your plane?
I can see it
all right.
Ready for me to give it to him?
Okay. Yes, sir. We're ready for you to give it to them, sir.
Russia.
Communist.
All right. Wendy?
Union.
Socialist.
Okay, Don.
Socialistic.
Soviet.
That's right.
Excuse me.
We have Soviet on the board, Tom.
Right, I have to guess.
Yes, sir.
Communism.
Is it communism? No, it's not. All right.
Not on this show.
No, you better believe it. Next word, please. This is a capitalist show if I ever saw one. Don, please.
Blasting.
We'll allow that, please. Go ahead.
Dynamiting.
No. Wendy?
Bombing. Explosion.
Form of the word.
Explode.
Yes, you'll allow that. Okay. Oh, that's right. Ian, we don't worry about it. Soviet exploding. Is that okay?
Sonmei?
Yes.
Sputnik.
Is it Sputnik? Okay, it could have been Sputnik. Absolutely. Next word, please. There it is. Wendy, continue.
Mittens.
Gloves.
Yes. Soviet exploding and gloves. Is that okay?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's deep.
I don't know. Mercy. Everybody out there know? Do you have an idea what it is?
Yeah.
Oh, you do not. Do you really? Okay, next word, please. Oh, I'm sorry. We have to go over to Tom, don't we? No, you guess. Where are we? We just guessed. We're going to another word. Next password for you and the audience at home. Here we go. Thank you. You know, I think what happens, I get so involved here that I forget I have to run this thing, and I'm playing the game with you. Whose turn is it?
Mine.
Okay. Thanks, Wendy. Lead us off, would you, Wendy, please?
Sylvester.
Stallone.
Aha. Yes. Soviet, exploding, gloves, and Stallone.
Is it Rocky IV?
Is it Rocky IV? Didn't mean film. What does exploding mean? What happens in the movie? The exploding, when the gloves hit, you mean? Oh, that's right. That was, okay. I had no idea why Stallone would be exploding, but okay.
We're the only people in the world that haven't seen it, I'm sure.
Yeah, no, I've seen it too, and I didn't get it. That's what really upsets me. Wendy is leading $300 to zero for Don at this point, and we know what that means. It means the cash word. So if you're ready to go, you'll have three chances, three clues to convey that word to Wendy. As you know, we'll show the folks at home what the cash word is. As I said, it's worth $2,000 for you. Take a look, Shaquay, if you will, and off we go.
Choose.
Select.
All right, clue number two.
Rather.
Second.
All right, clue number three.
Choice.
Perhaps.
Oh, okay. Very good clues. I had a rhyme, but I don't know if it would work. Defer.
Prefer.
Yeah, but
perhaps,
that's...
Perhaps, it was like right
but,
here.
But you had real good clues in rather. I mean, those are good clues as well. Okay, too bad. Next time the cash word's worth $3,000. With the score of $300 for Wendy and zero for Don, at this point, we will change partners right now, gang. If you will, we'll break away for a commercial message and come right back. Hey, we're right back.
join me, Bob Eubanks, for my picks from Card Sharks, Match Game, Hollywood Squares, Family Feud, and The Newlywed Game. It's the best of Bob during Bobtober on Buzzer.
Starts tomorrow at 8.
Jacquet and Tom, given the clues, if you're ready to go, here's the $300 puzzle. We're playing for $10,000 over there. And off we go. We have the word, please, Jacquet.
Pack.
Knapsack.
Okay, Tom?
Empty.
Full.
You. Jacquet?
Ooh. Pack.
Sack?
Oh. All right, fourth and final clue.
Remove.
Replace.
No, the word was fill. Fill was the word. We put it on the board and no.
I didn't mean empty.
But
like
I guess.
Not full, I meant empty out, you know?
Okay, I want to ask you about a clue we could have given later. I better not do it now, because if you know me, I'll give the whole thing away. Next word, please. I had an idea for a clue. Is that okay?
Amphetamine.
Sedative.
Okay. Tom? Okay.
Aspirin.
Tablet.
Is that okay?
Tablet.
Anison?
Fourth and final clue.
Medicine.
Pill.
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, hey, we could have done that faster, couldn't we? Novamed, or whatever they call it.
Oh, one of those, yes. We have Phil and Pill. Wendy, for the game for you.
Is it a pharmacy?
Is it a pharmacy? Ooh, good guess.
Sure
next,
was.
Next word, please. I don't have an idea yet. Tom?
Physician.
Doctor.
Yes. Excellent clue. Phil, Pill, and Doctor. Wendy, for the game.
Could it be a prescription?
Aha! Uh-huh. Could it be a prescription? Yeah, it is. Didn't need drug it, didn't need slip. Nice going. She won that game. She won the game.
She gets to play for $10,000.
Oh, for heaven's sakes.
Congratulations to Wendy. It means we must say goodbye to Don, and I'm sorry, sir, that you didn't win any more
good
money.
Experience.
Thank you for coming.
Enjoyed
we'll
it.
Break away for commercial messages. We'll be right back. $10,000 over there.
What a handsome fellow.
Yes, he is. Distinguished. Imagine how great he looked in his Air Force uniform.
Was he an Air Force?
Yeah, Air Force. That's why I flew all the different planes. You can see
a verb and a condition.
Yes, we have a new champion sitting here with us. As you can see, Wendy is with us, and Tom. I'm going to give you 10 words, beginning with the letter N and continuing through W. N through W. Everyone you get right, Wendy, I'll give you $100, as you know. And if you get them all, I will give you $10,000. Okay.
So we don't go for hippopotamus.
No. There's no H here at all. You have 60 seconds, Tom, as you know. Let's take a look at your first word. There it is on the board. Don't say anything. Good luck, Wendy. Here we go. Ready and go.
Nude.
Naked.
Oh.
That's right. Cereal.
Oatmeal.
Shorter.
Oats.
P.
House.
A place.
Veranda.
That's the word. Patio. Penthouse.
Swing. Older, farm, veranda, for pass.
Q.
Oatmeal.
Quaker.
Right.
R.
Living. Land. I'm at a hotel. Okay, pass, please.
Yes.
Nautical.
Sailor.
T.
Bath.
Tub.
U.
Aunt.
Uncle.
Right.
V.
Instrument.
Violin.
Right.
W.
Animal.
Okay. All right. You did very well. The tough one, the one that really got you was veranda. You didn't know veranda, which he kept saying, no, but it was a P. The word was porch. Porch. A front porch. The other one, The R was tough, too. You said Indian, what did you say, place?
Living land.
Living land, which was reservation.
Reservation.
Yeah. You switched to hotel.
But too late.
All right. You did fine. You now have, you got 7 words. We'll add $700 to your total. You have $1,300. The next time Super Pass will be worth $15,000, and you can come back. I will be back after this message. Porch is what blew your time. Brandon is the first thing.
Next, are you super password obsessed? Yes? Great! Well, stay right there, because Buzzer's got more super password coming your way. Stay tuned.
Okay. We are back. We now have $15,000 at stake over there in the end game. Wendy, you know you can go back. Gwendolyn went back 5 times, our ex-champ. Now, here's someone who's going to try and keep you from going back. However, our next player, Janet, come on in, won't you please? Hi, Janet.
How do you do?
It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Well, thank you for coming.
Thank you.
I didn't think Jim was going to let you go over there. He's hanging on to you. Tell us about yourself, please.
Well, my name is Janet Henderson. I live in Chatsworth, California. I'm a student full-time at Moore Park College, where I'm a sociology major and also a cheerleader.
Okay. Yes, I can see that. Maybe you'll give us a cheer later. It would be very nice. You're certainly cheering us up. You know what I mean? Okay. If you're ready to go, this is the $100 puzzle. I know I'm in trouble when Jean laughs. I mean, if I say something like that and Jean laughs, I'm in trouble. $100 puzzle, Jacquet and Tom giving the clues. Here comes your first word, please. Ready to go? All right, Jacquet, please.
Humongous.
Enormous.
That's it. That's the way to start. On the board, we have enormous. Janet, what could that possibly be?
Oh, hippopotamus.
We've had that this week, as a matter of fact, didn't we? Is it a hippopotamus? Next word, please. Cheque.
Durante.
Jimmy.
That's it.
Oh, what a great clue.
That's a great clue. Great answer, too. Great clue. Enormous and Jimmy.
I want to say Georgia.
Is it Georgia? I think I know what it is, and you know what it is, don't you, Jean?
Yes.
Yes, of course. Next word, please. There it is. Oh, yes, I know what it is, Jackie.
Malden.
Carl.
That's it. Very nice. Enormous. Jimmy. Carl. Janet?
I have no idea.
Okay. You know, don't you, Jacquet?
I think so.
You know, don't you, Tom?
Many people know. So.
Wendy, do you know?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Next word, please. Jacquet?
Hey, we're batting a thousand. Streisand.
Barbara.
Okay, here we go.
You don't know! Go for it!
Enormous. Jimmy, Carl, and Barbara.
Oh. Everyone knows but me.
Yep.
I don't know.
I think the whole room knows. I can hear them screaming at home. Come on. All right, here we go. You better lock them out now. Oh, next word, please. Jackie?
Oh, my. xylophone.
Instrument?
Okay, Tom, your first chance to get in here.
Hammond.
Organ.
That's right. What a perfect clue. Perfect.
I do all the work and I tell you.
Oh, it's a perfect clue. Enormous, Jimmy, Carl, Barbara, and organ. Wendy?
Could it possibly be nose?
Is it nose? Yes. Too bad. You did all the work, got all the way down, and bang, you grabbed it. That's a perfect clue.
Do you know how many times the word nose was used?
Yes. Do you know or no? Did you say nobody knows?
Nobody knows. There's a lot of people knows.
Okay. $200 puzzle coming up. The cash word is worth $3,000. If you're ready, Janet and Wendy giving the clues, and off we go. First word, please. There it is. Janet, lead us off.
Faithful. True.
Okay. Wendy?
Devoted.
Dedicated.
Okay, Janet.
Faithful. Honest.
Fourth and final clue.
Wife.
Honorable.
No, okay, the word was loyal. We'll put it on the board. Aww. You had good clues. And there it is. Next word, please. $200 puzzle, playing for $15,000. Janet, lead us off.
Archie
Bunker.
That's it. Yeah. Loyal and Bunker.
The War of 1776.
Very good guess.
Is it deep,
the War of 1776? We know what you were driving at there. Here we go. Absolutely. Next word, please. Janet?
Brunette.
Blonde.
That's it. Very nice. Loyal
Bunker, and Blonde?
Sally Struthers.
Is it Sally Struthers?
Okay,
next word, please. Wait a minute. Oh, Janet?
Adolf. Say it again. Adolf. My accent.
Who's good?
Adolf.
Uh-oh. Wendy?
Adolf.
Hitler?
Yes. You wonder where that came from, didn't you? Loyal, Bunker, Blonde, and Hitler. Tom.
Is it Eva Braun?
Is it Eva Braun? Yeah, that's what it is. Didn't need Mistress.
Did you know Eva Braun?
Can you believe that?
Yeah.
Where that went.
I couldn't think of her name.
All right, I score. Wendy has $300. Janet is yet to score. We'll come right back after this message. Can you believe that? Here we are. We're going to have to break away and wish you a very pleasant weekend, and thank you for being with us, Shakay. Really appreciate it.
Thank
and Tom, you of course, and Janet, Wendy, we'll see you back here on Monday. No, we may not see you back on Monday, will we? What's that? In the week, yeah, because the tournament's next week. Okay. Well, thank you all, as I said before, for being with us. And wherever you are, enjoy yourselves this weekend. We'll see you Monday. Thanks for watching. Bye, everybody.
A member of our studio audience will receive the amazing new Smith Corona typewriter with Spellwrite 1 electronic dictionary. It actually catches your mistakes before you do. Spellwrite, furnished by Smith Corona. And some of our departing contestants will receive Dakota's fashionable bedspread, very fluffy and beautifully designed in contemporary applique graphics, plus two pillow shams and two decorated pillows furnished by Dakota. A Sears catalog gift certificate, a spring catalog with over 1,200 pages of ideas, the most complete catalog in America. There's more for your life at Sears. It's the Vissel three-way vac, broom vac, hand vac, tank vac, super powerful, extra versatile, no bags to buy, Vissel three-way vac. Gift certificates for Kentucky Fried Chicken and fresh buttermilk biscuits. You've got a right to chicken done right at Kentucky Fried Chicken. We do chicken right. Rich, creamy Heath ice cream bars with crunchy toffee tidbits mixed right in. That's why you can't beat a Heath. Take the fat out of frying. Reduce calories with Mazola No Stick, the only cooking spray made with pure Mazola corn oil. This is Gene Wood speaking for Super Password, a Mark Goodson.